Hey, I'm going to remind you of what I want you to remember when it comes to these quadratic functions. We have the quadratic function f of x is equal to 2x squared plus 5x plus 3. I know it's a quadratic function because of the square. This is a parabola, and since our a value is that 2, I know it's going to be a nice U-shaped parabola. And it's going to be just a little bit more narrow than our classic y equals x squared parabola because of the 2. To find the vertex, we use the formula for h, negative b divided by 2 times our a. Negative b will be negative 5 divided by 2 times our a. That'll be 2 times 2. That'll be 4. So our h value for our vertex is negative 5/4. Our k value for our vertex is what we get when we work the function for that negative 5/4. So that'll be 2 times our negative 5/4 squared, which would be a positive 25/16. Plus 5 times our negative 5/4, so that'll be negative 25/4 plus our 3. Let's simplify this a little bit. The 2 and the 16 cancels, leaves me an 8 low. That'll be 25/8. I'm going to go ahead and get a least common denominator here. Plus the negative 25 over 4 will become minus 50/8, and then our 3 will become 24/8. Add, subtract, simplify this a little bit, and we get our k value to be negative 1/8. So our vertex is h value, comma, k value. Okay? So if we were to graph that, we would have a nice little parabola. We'll be a little bit more exact with our parabola here in a few minutes when we find our intercepts. And then down here at the very bottom, we would have a minimum of negative 5/4. And this is a minimum, negative 1/8. We have a local minimum. That's what this point would be. And it would be at the negative 5/4. And its value would be that negative 1/8. Through the belly of the parabola, you'll have a line of symmetry. And that makes where the left and right sides are reflections of one another. That line of symmetry for this type of parabola will be a vertical line, so that'll be x is equal to your h value, negative 5/4. We'll find the intercepts. Let me go to another screen here. To find the x-intercepts, we solve this function for 0. So we take our 2x squared plus our 5x plus our 3, and we set that equal to 0 and we solve. Now this might factor, but I'm just going to use the quadratic formula. X is equal to a negative b, that'll be negative 5, plus or minus the square root of your b squared, that'll be 25, minus 4 times your a, which will be 8, times your c, gets that up to 24. And we'll divide that by 2 times our a, which would be 4. We have a negative 5 plus or minus inside the radical. 25 minus 24 is 1. The square root of that is 1. Since that worked out nicely, that tells me that it would have factored. But I used the quadratic formula anyway. Negative 5 plus the 1 is negative 4. Negative 4 divided by the 4 is negative 1. Negative 5 minus the 1 is negative 6. Negative 6 divided by the 4 is negative 3/2. Now remember, I like my intercepts as points. So that'll be the point negative 1, 0, and the point negative 3/2, 0. To find our y-intercepts, we just find f of 0. We'll plug in, I'm going to use a y instead of the f. I'm plugging in a 0 for the x's. That goes away. That goes away. And then we have the plus 3 on the end, and the y-intercept will be just that 3. As a point, please, that is 0, 3. Now, if I was to graph this, my vertex was at negative 5/4, so there's negative 1, there's negative 2. Put negative 5/4 right there. Negative 1/8, there's negative 1, so we'll put negative 1/8 about right there, so the vertex would be there. There would be your vertex. The intercepts, we had negative 1 here. here. We had negative 1/2, or negative 3 over 2, negative 1/2 right there. And we had a y-intercept of positive 3. You guys will do a better job with your graph paper, I have no doubt. Nice parabola, right side, and the left side. Use the table feature on your calculator to get a whole lot more points to make that a little bit more exact. And that's it. Make sure you have a nice day and hug you folks. Take care.